I've been using Windows 11 as my main operating system for about a month now, and I've been using my unattended Winstall version of Windows 11. And although I find it much better to use Windows 11 without all of the bloatware and unnecessary stuff running in the background, there are still some things I don't like about Windows 11, and that is the taskbar, start menu, and right-click menu. Now, the good news is there are a lot of programs that you can use to replace the shell in Windows 11, and that's what the next few videos are going to be about on my channel. If you want to check out the other videos, go ahead and look at the description of this video, and I'll have all of those videos linked in a playlist that you can go ahead and watch. And the software that we're going to be having a look at today is called Windhawk. And Windhawk is basically like a modding interface where you have a collection of customizations that you can add to Windows and some programs. So we're going to be downloading it and I'll show you how to use it in this video. To download it, you can just visit this webpage here and then click on download. And I'll obviously have this link in the description of the video as well. It'll download the file. If you do get any prompts, just click on keep so you can keep that file there. Then click on open file and that's going to launch the Windhawk installer. You have a few options here. You can do a standard installation, which will install Windhawk for all users on the computer, or you can extract a portable version of Windhawk. And in that case, all the configuration data will be stored in the application folder and no information is going to be written to the registry of the computer. Now for this video, I'm just going to use the standard installation method. If you do get any prompts, just click on yes. I'm going to leave the default selected here, but you can also change that if you want. Then just click on next, and then it's going to start installing and downloading any necessary dependencies that's needed for it to run. Then once it's finished, you can run Windhawk, and I'm just going to click on finish. And then it should open automatically. So this is what the interface looks like. You can click on the Explore tab up here to browse for more mods. And here you can also see the mods are basically listed from the most popular to the least popular, or with the most amount of users to the least amount of users. There's a few of these mods that I want to show you in this video specifically because we're having a look at replacing the taskbar and start menu on Windows 11. So let's start with the taskbar height and icon size mod. You can click on the details of this mod and then you can click on install. These mods are all open source and you can see that it's verified by this GitHub user here. So I'm just going to click on install here and it's then going to install that mod. So once it's installed, you can go to the settings tab here inside of Windhawk, and then you have control over the settings. What this specific mod allows us to do is to change the icon size, the taskbar height, and the taskbar button width. If we go to the details tab here, you can see this is basically what the taskbar looks like if you have these settings here, like it's listed below each of these screenshots that they have here. But for this example, let's change it to the small taskbar size, which is an icon size of 16 and a taskbar height of 34. So the icon size was 16 and the taskbar height was 34. I'm going to leave the taskbar button width on 44, but I'm guessing we're going to change that afterwards as well. If I click on Save Settings, you'll see that the taskbar has changed now and it's a lot smaller compared to the default Windows 11 taskbar. If we change the taskbar button width, if I change that to 20, for example, and save the settings, you'll see that Explorer needs to be restarted, so you'll need to click on yes for those changes to take effect. But now the buttons are much closer to each other, so this is a small taskbar with small taskbar buttons. Basically, you just have these three settings that you can set and customize the taskbar size and icons. Now, if you want to undo this, you can click on the disable button here. And as you can see, it's basically bugged out now, but that's because we need to restart File Explorer. And to do that, I'm just going to open the Task Manager and then find the Windows Explorer process on here and then restart the task. And then you'll see the Windows 11 taskbar is now back to default. If you tested out the mod and you don't want to use it, you can just disable it or you can completely remove it from Windhawk. And I'm going to remove this mod from Windhawk just as an example to show you. And then we can go back and explore the other mods again. So one of the other popular mods here is the taskbar volume control. So if you click on the details and we install this mod here, what this allows you to do is you can basically just hover your mouse over the taskbar and then use your scroll wheel to scroll up or down, and that's going to change the volume of Windows. So that's a nice quality of life thing to have in Windows, and this works wherever you have the mouse on the taskbar. You can even have it over an icon and then change the volume without having to click on the flyout menu here and then change the volume here. You'll see if I disable the mod and then hover my mouse over the sound icon here and move the scroll wheel up and down, you can see that the volume is changing, and that's a default feature in Windows 11, but the mouse cursor has to be over the sound icon like I have it now. It won't work if you just hover it over the taskbar, but that's what this mod is for here. You can just hover it over the taskbar and then scroll up or down to change system volume. I'll leave that installed for now. Then the next thing we can have a look at here is the Windows 11 Start Menu Styler. So let's go ahead and install that. Now, as you can see, we should also check out the Windows 11 Taskbar Styler and the Windows 11 Notification Center Styler, which you can use with this mod here. But basically, this mod allows you to add themes to the Windows 11 Start Menu. So you have the No Recommended section. Basically, this removes the Recommended section. So if you didn't know, it's really hard to get rid of this Recommended section here. You can't actually get rid of it completely using the stock Windows 11. If you go to the Personalization settings and you go to the Start button, you can basically turn off these settings here, and then you'll see that it just says the Recommended section has been turned off, but it still takes up all of the space on the Start menu here, and you can't get rid of it. So as an example, if we go to Settings and we select the No Recommended section theme and we click on Save Settings and I open the Start menu now, the recommended setting is completely gone. And judging by the screenshot here, you can see that you can fill up the entire Start menu with pinned icons if you want to pin all of your apps to the Start menu. Now, you also have some other options here, like a side-by-side Start menu. And instead of looking at all of these screenshots here, let me actually show you what each of them looks like. So I'm just going to change the theme to the side-by-side theme and then save the settings again. Now, if we open that, we have the pinned icons here. We have the recommended section, which has been turned off. And then we have this all apps list here, which isn't possible in the stock Windows 11. Then there's also a side-by-side 2 setting where it basically has the all apps list here on the left and then the pinned apps on the right, but you still have the recommended section here, which isn't removed in these themes here. Taking a look at the other themes, we have a side-by-side minimal. So let's go ahead and save that. And this actually represents Windows 10 a lot better, where you have all of the apps here on the left and you only have the pinned icons here on the right with no recommended section. In my opinion, so far, this is the best Start menu that we've looked at now. If we have a look at some of the other themes, like the translucent Start menu, we can see that the Start menu now has a translucent effect. There's also no recommended section, which is really good. And you can also go to all apps. So this is a nice option for those people who want to have a translucent Start menu. If we go back to the other themes, we've got a Fluent 2 Inspired. If we go ahead and save those settings, this is like a Fluent theme, which is a lot like the Windows 11 stock Start menu. But again, we don't have the recommended section, which is really good. Another theme that we have at the time of this recording is the Windows 10 theme. And this actually looks quite good as well, with a bunch of pinned apps. And you can also unpin these apps from the Start menu and pin your own apps to the Start menu. Another theme is the Windows 11 Metro 10. This also looks like Windows 10 inspired menu with pinned apps and then the recommended section. I've got to be honest with you, the one I liked the most is the side-by-side minimal Start menu, which is this one here. If there's a theme that has the side-by-side minimal Start menu with the translucent theme, I think that's what I would be using if I were using Windhawk as my main shell replacement for Windows. But I actually use another program that I'll be discussing in a future video, so keep an eye out for that. But that's it for the Windows 11 Start Menu Styler. So I'm going to leave that enabled. But let's also have a look at the Taskbar Styler and the Notification Styler mods. We have the Windows 11 Taskbar Styler, and here we have a collection of themes like the Windows XP theme, a Bubbles theme, a Translucent theme. Now, judging by these screenshots, I won't actually be using any one of these themes here. Maybe we can check out the Translucent Taskbar just as an example. And I'm just going to install this mod just so we can see what it looks like. So if we go to the Settings tab and we select a theme, let's just look at the Translucent Taskbar. And I'm guessing it's going to be best if you use the translucent theme for the start menu with the translucent taskbar. So then everything has this translucent look to it. I'm just going to leave it on the minimal start menu. And then I'm also going to remove the taskbar theme. This is all personal preference. If there's one of these themes that you think you might like, then go ahead and try out Windhawk for yourself. I mean, we can even try out the Windows XP taskbar theme. Now, this aims to recreate the Windows XP taskbar, but it's not the same as Retrobar. Retrobar does a better job of that, in my opinion. And you can go ahead and have a look at that video if that's something you're interested in. But for now, I'm just going to remove this taskbar styler mod. Now, you also have a taskbar clock mod, a taskbar labels mod, and a whole bunch of others. Then you can add this mod where you can use your middle mouse button to close an item on the taskbar, which is quite handy to have. As you can see, there are a ton of customizations that you can do here. You can also have the classic Explorer navigation bar. And this is also something we covered in a previous video with Explorer Patcher, where you can change this command ribbon here to the Windows 10 classic ribbon. And that's something I like having, so I'll install that mod. So if we go to settings and we change it to the classic ribbon, then we have the classic Windows 10 command ribbon. So that's something I like having in Windows 11. So I'm going to leave that enabled. And then another thing we can have a look at is the Windows 11 Notification Center styler. And basically this allows you to add the translucent theme to the notification pane. So I'm not going to be looking at that in this video, but if you want to use the translucent taskbar and start menu, then you can also add that. So everything has that translucent look. Now, like I said before, Windhawk has a lot of different mods that you can add to Windows, and going through every single one of them in this video is just going to take way too long, and I'm not going to do that. But I've had a look at what I wanted to have a look at, and that is the start menu styler, which gave me this start menu right here, and then also the taskbar height and icon size. I think I'll enable that as well and just install it again, because I'd like the taskbar to be a little bit smaller, so I can maybe change this to 20. I'm just going to use these settings here, then restart File Explorer. So I like this taskbar and start menu change. And then the other thing that I also like is the File Explorer change, where I have the Windows 10 command ribbon here. The only other thing that I would still change here is to align the start menu to the left of the screen, and then also disable the widgets so I don't have that. And that'll leave me with Windows 11 looking like this, with a start menu that in my opinion is much better than the stock Windows 11 start menu. Now, with regards to Windhawk, if you click on the home button, you can see all of the mods that you have installed here, and you can easily enable or disable any mods that you've installed here. Some of the changes will be immediate, and the other changes you'll have to restart the Windows Explorer process for that to take effect. But basically you'll have the stock Windows 11 options back after doing that. But if you wanted to enable any of these mods again, you can just do that by clicking on these sliders here, and it'll bring back the changes that you made earlier. And Windhawk will run automatically every time you launch your computer. You won't have to come and enable these settings every single time you launch Windows. Windhawk will just be running in the background. And if we have a look at the task manager here, it doesn't use a lot of resources at all, because it basically just overrides the shell with a bunch of registry entries and some other stuff. But right now in total, it's not even using 3 megs of RAM. So it really shouldn't give you any performance issues in Windows. So it is a very good option to use in Windows 11 if you want to change the taskbar, start menu, or any of those other hundreds of tweaks that you can get by exploring these mods inside of Windhawk here. Now, like I showed you before, one of the methods to remove these options here is by clicking on remove, so you can remove the mods. But if you want to install Windhawk altogether, you can do that by going to the installed apps on your computer, and you'll find Windhawk as one of the installed programs, and you can just go ahead and uninstall it from your computer. And then you'll also have the option of removing the program settings, which you'll want to do if you don't want to use the mods anymore. You have to remember that the mods won't work if you don't have Windhawk installed anyways. So you can just remove all of those settings as well if you don't plan on reinstalling Windhawk again on the same computer. And then you'll have Windows 11 back to the standard settings. If I have a look at the File Explorer, you can see that the Windows 11 command ribbon has also been restored. So that's another free program that you can use to replace the shell in Windows 11. And I hope you found some sort of value in this video. If you did, please give it a like. And if you want to support me and this channel, check out my YouTube members section. But with that being said, thanks so much for watching. I'll talk to you guys soon.